come here to launch this wonderful book about Champa. And she's 9 years old. My daughter is 8 and a half. And I got through this book. I read the first few pages, and finally I put it down. I said, no, I don't want to read this book. I want to know what you think. So I asked Nissa. I said, Nissa, what is this book about? You tell me. I want to know what your opinion is. And she turned around and she told me, you know, Mom, this book is about this girl, and she takes you through the whole year. She takes you through summer, spring, winter, rain, and Baisakhi. I said, okay, I didn't know you knew about Baisakhi also. She's like, yeah, you know, I actually learned so much just reading from this book, and there's so much. Before I had to stop her then and there, because I could have gone on for another 45 minutes, that's beside the point. But it was wonderful to see how much she just picked up the book and she didn't put it down. She read it till like 8:30 in the night, and she started it at 4:30 in the evening, and she finished it that same day. So it's interesting. I know it's interesting, otherwise she would have definitely put it aside. It's educational.
I think that's what's so amazing about this children's book, because when I was going through it, I was going through the one where she goes into the Himalayas.
Yeah.
And I was thinking, wow, it's teaching me geography, it's teaching me, you know, about family values, it's teaching me so many things. And I'm like not a child, I'm like pretty grown up, I know all these things. But there's just, and it's done in the most amazing way. It's just, it's a story. You know, and that's what we all do, the profession that we're in. We tell you stories, we make movies so that we can tell you stories. And, we, you know, she's writing these amazing books.
You know, the great part about our childhood was that we didn't have that many books at that point of time. We only had Amar Chitrakatha, which I think I read the whole 300, 400 books of. But at that point in time, we had more. I had my great grandmother and my grandmother who told us stories. So even Akbar, Birbal, we read them, yes. But before we read them, we heard them, which is exactly what Asha ji here is talking about. She's a grandmother, so she knows what she's talking about. She's probably narrated those Akbar, Birbal stories. I don't know how many times over. And you know, then she was like, okay, I'm sick of them, let me come up with Champa. Well, I read fiction, I read to entertain myself, I read books like Champa, I go pick up a lot of teenage fiction, I go pick up a lot of children's books, so I know what I'm talking about when I say that they're very, very hard to read. Harry Potter is a children's book, so I mean, if we're speaking about teenage fiction, that's such an intelligent book. Well, my take on Singham is that it's rocking, you must go see it. That's not why I'm here. But as far as his take on books is concerned, he reads a lot of recommended books. अगर उनको कोई हाथ में दे दे थमा दे किताब तो जरूर पढ़ेंगे, लेकिन मुझे नहीं लगता कि कभी उन्होंने जाके किताब खरीदी होगी खुद के लिए. नहीं. I think kids pick up what parents do. I think she's seen me reading so many times. She has no choice in the matter but to pick up a book herself. Also, I think it makes a difference when you read to them. So I am reading to my son currently. He's only 10 months old, but I'm still reading to him. I'm hoping that he'll understand something someday. So I'm reading to my daughter. I read to my daughter, even though she can read for herself. And I think it's what they see their parents doing. So I think it's basically you have to practice what you preach. I wouldn't say we read because she reads sometimes a little more intellectual stuff than I do.
I'll tell you what I do. I basically get Kajol reads everything, so I just get her to read everything, and then I just go to her and I'm like, baby, just tell me what the good books were and tell me what the boring ones were, because I'm not reading the boring ones.